Hello and welcome. My name is Dr. Robin, and in this video, we are going to look at the rights of drug administration. So, why should you know about medication rights? Why are you getting the recommended medication? Is there a medical reason? Do the benefits outweigh the risks? Did you provide an informed consent? We're going to learn if you can be forced to take a medication, the N code, medication errors, ARs, and the law. So let's find out what the rules are for medication administration. So medication rights. There are the original five rights of medication administration and four more that you may not be aware of. These rights are put in place to reduce medication errors and prevent harm to people. So the first one is the right reason. So why you're getting the medication. We'll do a medical history, find out if you have any allergies to the medication, your family history, past medical history, medications that you are presently on, etc., surgeries. Then there's the risk factors like hereditary, if you're immunocompromised in any way, allergic to any component of the drug, if there's any drug interactions or compatibility issues with medications that you're presently on. They're going to do investigation findings like your lab results, x-rays, vital signs, ultrasound, etc. And look at the symptoms that you're currently experiencing. The second one is the right person. It's one of the original five rights. You're going to ensure that the right person is receiving the medication or drug. You're going to check the ID. You need to check at least two sources to make sure you are giving the medication to the right person, even if you know them. You can even ask them to say their name and birth date for greater clarification, and ensure it is on the medication label as well. If there is any doubt that you are giving a medication to the wrong person, don't give the medication till you are sure you are giving it to the correct individual. Number three, the right medication. This involves reading the medication label on the bottle, including the brand name of the medication and the generic name of the medication if both are available, and make sure that you have a match and the spelling is the same. So the right drug is the one of the original five rights of the medication administration. The prescription should be verified that it is correct, and you might do that with your general practitioner. The label must correspond with the order, including the brand or generic name. And look specifically at the pill itself. If it does not look the way you remember the pill, or if you're unsure the medication is correct, you need to check it again with the pharmacist to make sure the medication is the correct one for you. You're going to look at the expiry date, it shouldn't be expired, and that the storage of the drug is correct. Like some medications must maintain a cold chain or a temperature restriction, like insulin, it has to be in the fridge, etc. And then you're going to look at the preparation and the administration. Both the preparation and the administration of a medical product must be performed by the same person. So one nurse can't draw up a medication and give it to another nurse to distribute. The right dosage. The right dosage is one of the original five rights of medication administration. You need to be aware of the strength of each medication you are taking or giving. Ensure the dose ordered is the dose dispensed or taken. If the medication is a liquid, you need to calculate how much of the liquid needs to be dispensed based on the dose ordered in the chart and the dose written on the bottle's label. Ask the pharmacist or your health practitioner anytime to check your calculations. If you are told to take three or more tablets, double check that the dose is correct. Many medication errors involve multiple tablets. And there's an importance of taking the medication as prescribed at the right dose for the right duration. So a lot of people quit taking their medications once they start feeling better, and this causes superbugs and mutations and decreases its effectiveness. Number five, the right route, is also an original right of the medication administration. This involves where and how the medication is given. The correct form of medication, the route and administration method as prescribed. The drug may be given in many ways and requires the correct position and landmarking. You can give it by the oral or through your mouth route. Most medications are taken by this route. These are tablets, liquids, and gels. There's endotracheal, which goes into the lungs. It sprays, aerosols, and liquids. Nasogastric tubes that go from your nose into your stomach to give you liquids and your medications that are crushed. Integumentary, which is your skin. It's absorbed through the skin. These are creams, lotions, ointments. Can be given rectally through suppositories like antiemetics and painkillers. Injections, there's intradermal injections just under the skin, interstitial, subcutaneous, intramuscular, and interosseous into the bone. There's intravenous medications through IV, antibiotics, medicated fluids, and TPN, total parenteral nutrition. Then there's others, medications that are applied to your eyes, like ointments and drops, to your ears, drops, or your nose with sprays or creams, etc. We also must follow the principles of infection prevention and control technique while we're doing the preparation and administration of medications so we don't get an infection. The right time is one of the original five rights of medication administration. Some medications need to be given at the same time every day or at the same time with relationship to meal times. So medications must be given within a 1 hour window in healthcare, and that's a half an hour before to 1/2 hour after the prescribed time. The right time and or duration of the prescribed medication, order or M. If no time is given or the medication label is different from what you were told, you need to verify this with your doctor or pharmacist. The healthcare professional must sign the drug order stating the exact time and date the medication was given. Just make sure you know the policy regarding your facility. Number 7, the right information provided. Before giving a medication to a patient, make sure that you talked with them about the medication, what it's for, and answer any questions they might have. So this provides the basis for informed consent, and it may include the benefits of the medication and how it works, possible risks like allergic reactions, cardiac issues, liver side effects or kidney damage, interactions with other medications, supplements or substances that you are taking, side effects like nausea, vomiting, fast heart rate, rashes, trouble breathing. Make sure that you are informed of the minor side effects and the rare severe side effects of the medication. You must know this information to make an informed decision or consent. What to do if there is an unwanted reaction, and information about the consequences of not taking the medication, and clarification of any questions that you might have regarding the medication. It should be answered at this time. Number 8, the right to refuse. It is your legal right to refuse a medication. Your right to deny must be respected. If someone in a facility is trying to provide you with a medication and you refuse, they must legally document your refusal and the reason for your refusal in the Medical Administration Record, or MAR, and the chart. The medical doctor may also be informed. Right now, there's a current global experiment, and any participation in an experiment requires voluntary consent. This means that the person involved should have the legal capacity to give the consent and should be so suited as be able to exercise free power of choice without the intervention of any element or force. Should be so situated as to be able to exercise free power of choice without the intervention of any element of force, fraud, deceit, duress, overreaching, or other ulterior form of constraint or coercion, and should have sufficient knowledge and comprehension of the elements of the subject matter involved as to be able to make an understanding and enlightened decision. This latter element requires that before the acceptance of an affirmative decision by an experimental subject, there should be made known to him the nature, duration, and purpose of the experiment, the method and means by which it is to be conducted, all inconveniences and hazards reasonably to be expected, and the effects upon his health or person which may possibly come from his participation in the experiment. 9. Right results, response. Did the medication or drug achieve the desired effect? Make sure you document the response the patient has had to the medication. For example, if oxytocin, a pain medication, was given, you need to document the degree to which the medication alleviated the pain. So asking a client to choose on a scale from 1 to 10 can provide an effective rating from the client's perspective. Pain is very subjective, meaning everyone responds differently to pain. Or if the medication was for hypertension, you want to document the blood pressure before and after giving the medication to monitor its effectiveness. Alternatively, you can keep a journal about how you are feeling with a new medication. Medication errors. This includes prescribing, order communication, product labeling, packaging, compounding, dispensing, distribution, administration, education, monitoring, and use. If you make a documentation or medication error and correct it, you circle and initial the mistake and make a notation that says you made a mistake and what you did to rectify it. Do not cross out any documentation you make or write over anything you have written. Check your facility's policy. Recent studies of medical errors have estimated errors may account for as many as 251,000 deaths annually in the United States, making medical errors the third leading cause of death. Adverse reactions. Any clinical manifestation resulting in undesired, unintended, or unexpected reactions that are consequent to and caused by the administration of the medication. An incident report is required for adverse events, and if it's a V, ideally there is a duty to report it to VAERS and several other V safety monitoring systems. Any person can fill in a report as well. At present, the information available about adverse events is said to be representative of only 1% of the injuries. The N code. It states that certain basic principles must be observed in order to satisfy moral, ethical, and legal concepts. So, 1. The voluntary consent of the human subject is absolutely essential. 2. The experiment should be such as to yield fruitful results for the good of society, unprocurable by other methods or means of study, and not random and unnecessary in nature, i.e. the CEV. 3. The experiment should be so designed and based on the results of animal experimentation and a knowledge of the natural history of the disease or other problem under study that the anticipated results will justify the performance of the experiment. 4. The experiment should be so conducted as to avoid all unnecessary physical and mental suffering or injury. 5. No experiment should be conducted where there is a prior reason to believe that death or disabling injury will occur, except perhaps in those experiments where the experimental physicians also serve as subjects. The principles continue. Number 6. The degree of risk to be taken should never exceed that determined by the humanitarian importance of the problem to be solved by the experiment. 7. Proper preparation should be made and adequate facilities provided to protect the experimental subject against even remote possibilities of injury, disability, or death. 8. The experiment should be conducted only by scientifically qualified persons. The highest degree of skill and care should be required through all stages of the experiment of those who conduct or engage in the experiment. 9. During the period of the experiment, the human subject should be at liberty to bring the experiment to an end if he has reached the physical or mental state where continuation of the experiment seems to him to be impossible. 10. During the experiment, the scientist in charge must be prepared to terminate the experiment at any stage if he/she has probable cause to believe, in the exercise of good faith, superior skill, and careful judgment required of them, that a continuation of the experiment is likely to result in injury, disability, or death to the experimental subject. The law. A M or suggestion does not equal law. It is against the law to force anyone to take something against their will. The government or other authorities can't physically force you to get V'd. There is no specific law requiring that a person be V'd. M's can only be enforced when there is a documented grave danger that necessitates the V. OSHA rules typically take 7 years to develop. This rule to MV is being issued through an emergency temporary standard, a process that allows OSHA the provision to address a grave danger that is aimed at protecting against the hazard. This provision only stands if there is a state of an emergency. World governments have extended the emergency state during this period, allowing them to make these and other rulings. The Department of Justice ruling Section 564 of the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act does not prohibit private businesses from imposing VMs. The Department of Labor's Occupational Safety and Health Administration, OSHA's, continues to work on a rule to enforce this VCM. There are many ongoing cases being tried in the courts, and they will likely have the final say on whether the M's are legal. Only 1 out of 7 previous VMs have held. The rest were denied. So the one that did held was the SP. As of July 2021, more than 40 states have introduced legislation restricting VMs. A group of 24 Republican attorneys generals warned in September that they would go to court to fight what they said was an illegal M. State laws. When a federal law conflicts with a state or local law, the federal law will supersede the other laws. The courts therefore have held that the states do not have the power to nullify federal law. So we'll see where that goes. A new law passed in Iowa that expands an individual's ability to refuse the V and keep their job or get unemployment benefits. Lawmakers in Florida, Iowa, Kentucky, Tennessee, Wyoming, and North Dakota have already completed special sessions and passed bills aimed at nullifying new federal mandates. The new Iowa law directs employers to waive requirements for any workers who say they believe that the V would hurt their health or well-being or conflict with their religion. So the takeaway, my message here is that you are responsible for your own health and safety when it comes to taking any medications. Ensure you are informed about the drug, how you are supposed to store it, take it, and the benefits, risks that can be expected. And know why you are taking it and recognize you can refuse if you feel it is causing more harm than good. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed my video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Namaste.